Welcome to a new video. Today it's all about reverbs in Bitwig Studio. If you want to save some money on Bitwig Studio and the upgrade plans, and you want to support my channel and my content, then go to my webpage, use the link to the Bitwig store, use my code and save 10% on the regular price. So here we are in Bitwig Studio 3.1 Beta 6, and I already loaded up a pulley synth. It's some kind of synth sound, and we are adding one reverb. And I remove my EQ2 here in the WetFX box because I have a default setting for the reverb, so I don't have to add my EQ in the WetFX all the time. So you can see we have now a pretty basic reverb effect here, and it's basic for a purpose, because in Bitwig all the default instruments and effects are pretty basic because you can combine them. When you come from Cubase or Logic, you have your just normal VST insert chain, so you have a reverb effect somewhere in between. And then you can add effects in front, in the pre, and then you can add effects in post, in the insert chain. But inside Bitwig Studio, you can combine multiple devices, you can nest them, and you can also branch out in different audio paths. And there's a lot of stuff you can do. You can also add modulation and so on. So it's for a purpose that you have instruments and audio effects that are pretty basic because you can combine them. That's the specialty of Bitwig Studio, so we have to use this stuff. Okay, so when we have this reverb effect here, you can already hear that it sounds pretty metallic. Sometimes that's exactly what you want, but maybe not every time. So you have to add some effects. So maybe we can go here to the Tank FX to have the late mix, some effects to the feedback chain. Maybe go for a filter, remove the top end a bit, and maybe go for an chorus because this gives us some nice pitch changes. So that's something we can do. Maybe here in the end of the WetFX, we can also add a filter. And maybe to bring in some dynamic, we add an audio rate modulator. So everything that goes into the filter here is analyzed. And, or maybe let's go for an audio sidechain. So we can use the amplitude that goes in and modulate the filter just a bit. So now we have some kind of dynamic effect here in the WetFX, and maybe we can add a delay at the end of the WetFX box. also go for an EQ, remove some of the top end here and bring maybe some of the mid lows a bit up. And maybe add another chorus at the end. Maybe you can also use this sidechain modulator on this EQ here and maybe change the frequency of the low band. So all I'm trying to do here is basically bring in some small modulations, make it more dynamic, and so it doesn't sound so static anymore. So this would be something you can call a new reverb and maybe give it a name, my reverb, and then go here, save preset to library, and call it my reverb and give it some tags, and then you can use it next time instead of the basic reverb and start from zero. You just start with your just made preset. So another thing you could do is maybe we just delete this here and use another reverb and go with the basic one. Maybe remove the EQ at the end and go also for chorus. Okay, and then we choose to select this reverb and hit Ctrl and G to group this. So we have now an FX layer with a reverb inside. And in front of the reverb, we're going for an just select the filter and go for a bandpass. Maybe this. And then select this, duplicate, go for a different frequency, duplicate, different frequency, duplicate, different frequency, duplicate, different frequency, and so on. Maybe you think, well, that's weird, it's just multiple reverbs. But when you look inside of VST reverbs, a lot of VST developers do a lot of this stuff under the hood. There are a lot of ways you can create reverbs, and also you can do this all this stuff inside Bitwig Studio with just nesting the devices. So you can come up with your own reverb solutions, and I just show you some examples here. It's nothing you have to do. So now we have your multiple filters, and maybe in the last one we go for the maybe we can modulate this here with an LFO, so you have something you can sync to your beat. maybe just try and use different settings for different layers, yeah? This could be also interesting. So this is also a possibility. Then maybe you can go for a reverb here and use at the end maybe a pitch shifter. Let's remove this. Or maybe add a reverb inside of the reverb. It's also possible. Or you take your reverb and use a pitch shifter in front of it. Use maybe low grain size. Okay. Combine this or select both, then hit Ctrl and G so you have a layer again. Now we can create multiple layers, different pitches. Seven. That's something you can do. Then you can go for a tree monster here. This for reverb effect. Or use the reverb inside this, so we have a thank you. maybe you go for reverb and use the tree monster here inside of this. Just mix it in. Something like this. Also, you can try just pitch shifters. That's also possible. Something I really like to do is maybe use a chain. Put in a pitch shifter here and just bring it up one, pitch it one semitone up. Go grain pretty low, maybe at the macro. So we can change this. And what else? Maybe make it possible to change the mix. Okay, so now we duplicate this and we go minus one. So we pitch it one semitone up and here we pitch it one semitone down. But now we have the effect of the pitch shifter here happening. So let's look how this sounds. So maybe let's duplicate this multiple times here. Let's look how this sounds. Maybe at the peak limit at the end. Bring all this down. Okay, okay. Maybe not the reverb sound you are going for, but it's a possibility. Okay, another thing you can do is use the blur device, which are actually just all pass effects on the left and the right channel. So maybe. Maybe use chain, so we can group this up into a chain. So, and then maybe after this we go for a chorus. Okay, so we can close this down, duplicate this multiple times. Or maybe we make it use a macro here and change some of the settings just randomly. Thank you. can duplicate this, change the settings, duplicate it. Select everything and, or maybe use again a chain device and put everything inside this chain device. So now we have my reverb 2. So now you created basically your own reverb with the Plur device, which is just some all-pass filters. I think there's one trick I didn't show, and that's using the delay. And I'm using, most of the times, I'm using a reverb in front of a delay. So the reverb is more for diffusing the signal. So it doesn't need to be long, just to have some kind of room effect. Something like this. And after this, we use a delay. And because of the diffusion, it doesn't sound so much like a delay. Because the steps of the delay are not so audible anymore, because you have this big diffusion in front of the delay. And maybe you can combine this here and use different settings for different layers. Maybe this way. Maybe something like this. This way. So this way you can create all kinds of diffusion effects and have your own reverbs in basically seconds. You can save it as preset and can create thousands of multiple different reverb effects and just go with your ear in and try to listen to the sound, tweak it until you like it, save it as preset, and then you have a reverb you like. So that's it for this video. If you have some questions, then you can leave the questions in the comments below. And if you like the content, then you can give me a thumbs up, and maybe you can also become a Patreon on my Patreon page if you want, but you don't need to, but you can if you want to. And also you can subscribe to the channel. That's a pretty nice concept, because every time I make a video, you get a notification. That's very nice. And yeah, that's it. I see you in the next video. Thanks for watching, and bye.